we'll see evaluation rules in different scenarios. So for that, the first scenario, what I'm expecting is that if I go to my present contracts, if I go back and edit my contract name to Apex to Salesforce Apex 2, now what happens in this case, I don't get any error. It will get saved. But I'm expecting to implement in a condition saying that if the record is created and if the account contract name is getting updated, I should throw an error saying that, hey, you cannot update contract name for the active contracts. You understood this? If the contract is active, then you should not allow. I mean, they can have a edit button, but still you need to restrict in a way that they cannot modify the value. Okay. So here we need to imagine two things. If the record is already there, when you say the record is going to update, I mean, with what you can say that this value is changed or value is not changed. So in this case, what we'll be checking? We'll be checking what is my old value and what is the new value, right? By comparing old value with new value, then only we can say the values are getting updated. Not only here, everywhere, what is the old and what is now. If we can see both, if they are looking same, even though after some time, so we'll say they are same, no progress. If they are different, we'll say that they are changing, right? By comparison of old value. The same thing in validation, we also have a concept called, you can also read what is the old value for that particular field. What is the old value for that particular field? To get there, so I'm going to set up on which object we are talking now. We are talking about present contact, the object what we created as a custom object. Go to object manager and this look for a present contracts in the validation rule. So I'll be creating a new contract name check. This will restrict user to update the contract name if the contract is active, right? The contract is active, then we are restricting. For this, first thing what we need to check whether the record is updating or not. First, we need to check whether the record is updating or not. So we know the logical operator. The first thing we need to check here is whether the record is updating or not. How can we check record is updating or not? We have a function called here isNew. There is a function called isNew. What it is saying here, check if the record is created. Record is new and returns true. If it is new, otherwise it returns false. It means that if you are trying to create a record for a first time, it will return true. If the record is updating, what happens? This will be ultimately this is false, right? If this is false, then we can assume that the record is not a new record. This is an existing record. So I'll say, but as you know, under false, comma, true comma true, what happens? This is false and ultimately outcome is false, right?
Yes.
So for this, before we go further, now even though if it is a false, basically the logically it is false, but for us, if it is false, then it is a right data, isn't it? If it is false, then it is a right data. So how can you convert false to true? Can say not of, right? We have a not function. Not of true is false, not of false equal to true, right? Not of, yeah. And first we check it. Okay, we got to know in this case the record is updating, right? If this is true, it means that record is getting updated. Let's talk about the next one. What is the next one?
Let's do this.
Whether the field value, the contract name is changed, there is a function we have called isChange. What is saying? Check if the field value is different from the prior value, returns true. It means that if the value is changed, then what happens? It returns true, right? That's what he is talking about, description. Check if the field value is different from the prior value in the sense the old value, and returns true. If the value is differ, only if it returns true when value is differ. I mean, if it is Salesforce Apex is the old value. If I update Salesforce Apex 2, now value is differ, isn't it? If I try to save, that time it returns true. That's the same condition we are expecting, right? We should not allow, contract name to be updated. So what I'm saying, I'll take is change. What is the field name here? Insert field. And we have a contract name, isn't it? This is contract name. That is contact name. This is contract name. So we have a field called contracts name. Yeah, this is the field, contracts name. We have two things. One is contracts. The other is contact. So now I check. Now let me check my validation, whether my validation, oh, no errors. So let me say, you are not allowed to update the contract's name with the here we need to check another condition. We need to check this active is true or false, right? So for that, what we can say, insert field active. Because this is a checkbox, this is true. I can say not off. When I say not off, what happens? If it false, then only it will say true. But in this case, when it is active, I don't want to allow. So this is the case, isn't it? You understood this? And for Boolean, you don't need any comparison operator because Boolean value checkboxes is true or false. If you kept like this, it returns either true or false, right? So here you have, if it is not a new, then we will get return. If the actual field value is changed, then this will be true. If it is checked, then this will be true. All three trues will result like an outcome is true, and you will get a validation error message. And I'll say account name, contracts name, and I saved it. We'll see the same validation rule that we can write in a multiple different formats. So what I'll do, I'll just try and update to Apex 2. If I try to save, then you are not allowed to update the contract's name when it is active. What I'll do, I'll just uncheck it. And I'll say, now it should allow, right? Because this is not active. If it is not active, I should allow my user to update the record, isn't it? Right?
Yes.
So if I make active, if I change anything, but now it should not allow because this is active now. I should get an error saying that it is active, so you can't update it. So now I am allowed to update. So my, as per our expectation, it is working fine, isn't it?
Yes.
We'll see the same validation rule in writing in a different formats. See, validation rule is not something like you need to follow the same pattern. There are many ways, like the way you think, the way your logical thinking works, you can write the validation in a different ways. It's not a standard format. From here, you need to understand the basics. How can you use the functions? It doesn't matter that if this is the scenario comes, you have to follow this. No. You can write however you want it, however your logic works. I'll show the same example with a different pattern. Instead of is change equal to name, I'll take off this. You can see, I'll take off this. We also have another function to read a value called prior value. There is a concept called prior value. Prior value in the sense, it will get the old value. Prior value means, what it's saying, returns the previous value of the field. What is the field that I need to use? Contracts name. Not equal to contracts name. This is also a valid one, you know. Even this is a valid one. Now I can see what I did. Instead of is change directly, see, is change what it do, it does the same thing. It gets the old value, it checks with the new value. If it is not equal, then it will return true. Now also it's same, right? Now if I go back, if I try to edit, if I say 3, I'll get an error message ultimately, isn't it? So value is changed. If I uncheck, then it will say. You understood this, right? So you don't want to follow the same pattern. Now here you need to understand only one thing, is that prior value. What is the other function that you had now? What is the other function you had here? Prior value means
changed.
prior value means it will get the old value. So Prague, you have a question?
No, I clear.
Yeah. And Avinash, you have a question?
No, sir.
Okay. So let me remodify with other way of writing. It's not just this. Let me rewrite in a other formats. So you have a prior value and not equal to null. So I'll take off all this. Till now we are using and conditions, but we also know there is a condition called if, right? There is a function called if. What is if? Generally, how we write in if condition? We'll say if condition, and then within the flower braces, we'll write the method body, isn't it?
Yes.
And then next one, we'll say else. If it is not that, what is the else condition, right?
Yes.
Now, in validation rule, if was little upgraded, if, open bracket, close bracket, first one, logic condition, comma, what if true? What if true? It means that here you need to write method body, true method body, and then you can say what if false. So now what happened, instead of having the condition something like this, it got upgraded. I mean, little modified. Logic will go in the first part. And the second part, if the logic is true, then this will be returned. If the this is false, then this will be returned. You understood this?
So in Salesforce, we write the if logic in the same way.
No. Only in validation rule. I'm talking about only in the validation rule. In the programs, you will be writing the same thing.
Okay.
Only in the validation rule I'm talking about. So what is our logic? First logic here. I'll just say enter. So what is my logic here? The same thing. And off. We need to write that and only, no matter what. Okay. So and off. What is this? Not off.
Prior.
Is new first. Right? First we need to check whether it is updating or not, isn't it? And then comma, I'm not changing so much, is change, C-H-A-N-G-E-D, is changed of what the name of the field is name, comma, because I remembered the API names I'm using straight away, so if it is true, what I need to prove, you can also return a value here, you can also return values, but in this case, it is a validation rule, right? In the validation rule, you need to return only true or false. If it is a foreigners, you can return a value saying that change. So this will be updated in the formula field. But in this case, because of validation rule only expects a return value should be a Boolean type, either true or false. If it is true, I'll say true. If it is false, I'll say false. If it is true, I'll say false. So now this is updated. So I'll check my syntax, whether my syntax is right or wrong. Oh, this is correct. And I'll save it. Now let me refresh it. I'll try to update up to some extra thing. I'll save it. So you got the error, right? So from this, what we understood, there is no limitation that you have to follow the same pattern while writing a validation rule. You have an option, however your logical thinking works, you can write. You understood this? My stress point here is, however your logical thinking works, you can write that way. Clear?
Yes.